Oh, New Horizons, you finally did it. You added something that the community wanted since the second everyone started playing the game. The most recent update added 100 extra slots, 50 regular design slots and 50 pro designs for our customization needs. Now we have so many that a lot of people are either overwhelmed with what they can do or overcompensated and found too many designs to download and have yet again run out of space to hold the awesome creations they found. These are problems we don't think about when we're crying about the additional stuff that we want added to the game. You do have to make room for that standalone Brewster Cafe, you know. Unless it gets thrown in the museum, then it's fine. Custom designs have been a mechanic in Animal Crossing since the beginning. In the GameCube days, we were limited to just clothes and umbrellas, but it was still fun to mess around with and try your hand at a little bit of fashion design. Back in 2002, we were given 8 design slots. Yep, 8. Granted, they couldn't be applied to as many items as we have now, but still, 8. And you couldn't just draw whatever you wanted and have it fit well. There were no pro designs, it was just a flat 32 by 32 pixel square that we could try to do something with. The problem with the GameCube version is whatever appeared on your shirt also appeared on your hat. So if you're trying to do any specific shape, it would replicate itself onto your hat, but warp into an interesting design. Each installment to the series gave us a little bit more for our designing needs. From being able to place designs on the ground to actually being able to design hats, and utilizing QR codes which allowed the pixel artists of the community to share their art with those of us who maybe aren't as skilled. Until finally we got the best quality of life improvement with New Horizons. 50 design slots, 50 pro design slots, and 9 different types of clothing design options. While these seem phenomenal on paper, the additional mechanics like design capabilities with New Horizons have made these original number of design slots seem like not nearly enough. We finally have an easier way to place our designs as paths, can customize a ton of furniture, and we have a ton of room to place said furniture all around our island. All of a sudden, 50 design slots just doesn't do it anymore. Any decent path takes up at least 9 slots, not to mention your island's flag, stall patterns, and the hundreds of possibilities for the most amazingly versatile furniture item in the game, the simple panel. These 50 design slots fill up quickly, and if you share your island with other users, all of you share the same design slots. With the latest update, the developers have doubled our number of slots. Thank God. You can purchase these with Nook Miles from the Nook Stop and Resident Services. I've been holding back from downloading so many beautiful works of art. It's like the world has opened up. There's so many possibilities, and now I am overwhelmed with what to do next. So what the heck do you do with your newfound blank squares of opportunity? If you're like me, you've been avoiding downloading these amazing designs because you can't justify taking up 9 design slots for this cool path you saw that one time. Or you avoid celebrating holidays with your different variations because even though it would have looked really cool to have some shelves in your cafe with gingerbread cookies, you lost the design code for the original shelves you found in the first place, so you won't be able to go back and replace them and are afraid to get rid of the design altogether. There are some really well-drawn seasonal items out there. Many of them are for stalls, simple panels, or paths, but they help add some good feels to your island and match the seasonal decorations that the game provides us with already. Along with the new slots, the developers gave us new items to create designs for. Umbrellas, Uchiwa fans, flags, and standees. There are so many possibilities with these. People have been crazy creative with the new items. There are these amazingly drawn designs that use each item like they're supposed to be used. Wonderful umbrellas, highly detailed standees that can be used as a cute addition to take pictures with. And then, there are those that are taking these designs to the next level. Artists are turning the standees into buildings, boats, trains, and custom walls. These amazing people have come up with such great ideas to help us fancy up our islands. And then, there are the umbrellas. Because of the way the umbrellas are placed down, artists have used the orientation of them to create the illusion of a box. Doors have opened up and so many different ideas are being created. Everything from pet houses, flower boxes, game cubes, trash bins, pretty much anything that is a cube, including Dom in a box. Oh man, he's so sad. Someone get him out of the box. Oh, Dom in boxes. I get it. Okay. Someone even created the question mark item blocks from Mario Kart to add to the in-game Mario items that we've been trying to fit naturally somehow on our island. Many of you have already used up your slots. And to you, I say, yes, probably same here soon. My advice, try not to take designs that only have one use. I have this cool bell bag design for my money trees. It's not really necessary, since you can see that they are indeed money trees, but I thought it was well made and wanted the design on my island. Instead, to save space, I started trying to find designs that were versatile and could be used for multiple items like pillows, couches, bed quilts, etc. People in the Animal Crossing community are just downright incredible. The creativity, the art, the designs, it makes me excited to see what could possibly come next. Not only for user-generated content, but also for the future of New Horizons and the updates the game could possibly see. It makes me wonder if the developers know the amount of creativity that the Animal Crossing has to make these incredible designs. Did they know the back of the climbing wall was going to be used as a wall outside? Were they aware of how the simple panels, stalls, and solar panels would be used to make our own buildings? Probably not. But I love that they're trying to give us cool stuff. The level of customization with the umbrellas has come so far from New Leaf. Instead of just copying one triangle of design, they've allowed us to create every pixel the way we want. I'm sorry, I'm gushing like crazy. I just love how New Horizons is evolving, and I'm really excited for the future. What's your favorite new design? Found anything cool? Share it with others in the comments below, and I'll see you next time. Bye!